Oracle Crystal Ball is an excellent and easy-to-use tool for creating probabilistic models in Excel. A drawback of Excel is that it provides a single outcome or scenario. More sophisticated models might also include a worst-case and best-case scenario. But this is where it stops. The model takes single-point estimates for inputs. We know that these input variables may vary. They are surrounded with uncertainty. In real life, we do not come up with hard numbers, but rather provide estimates and ranges. In the probabilistic modeling approach, a Monte Carlo simulation generates thousands of scenarios instead of just one. Also, Crystal Ball allows for modeling each of the input variables with a probability distribution. This way, we can define ranges and include the uncertainty surrounding the inputs. We are going to look at an example from finance and banking. Financial institutions maintain loan loss provisions as a buffer against future losses. The loan loss provisions should equal the expected losses with a one-year horizon. The calculation is straightforward. It is a multiplication of three elements. 1. Exposure at default or EAD. This is the amount outstanding when the default occurs. 2. Probability of default or PD is the likelihood a client will default. 3. Loss given default is the actual loss percentage once a default occurs. Thanks to, for instance, collateral and guarantees, financial institution might recover part of the loss. Expected losses is equal to exposure at default times probability of default times loss given default. Or in acronyms. L is equal to EAD times PD times LGD. Let's take a look at an Excel example. We see that for a loan portfolio of 5.500 we need a capital buffer of 25. The PD and LGD input parameters might come from a statistical analysis of our historical loan portfolio. We know that these inputs may vary over time and that in our expected losses forecast we should include this uncertainty. It is common to model the probability of default as a log-normal distribution. The PD cannot be negative and has a long right-hand tail. Under adverse conditions, high losses may occur. Crystal Ball comes with a library of probability distributions. We select the log normal distribution. We can define the log normal distribution with a minimum, the mean, and the standard deviation. As we said, our historical data provide the mean and standard deviation. Now we move to the loss given default. Modelers often use the beta distribution for this variable. Let's assume that the financial institution has its sector specialists estimate the LGDs. Crystal Ball has a special case of the beta distribution that makes this task easy. The beta PERT distribution just calls for a minimum, the most likely value or mode, and the maximum. Given the nature of the LGD, the minimum is 0% and the maximum 100%. So, we only need to estimate the most likely value to define this distribution. In proper statistical terms, the most likely value is the mode. Crystal Ball allows us to copy the distribution definitions. If we set up our spreadsheet in a clear and transparent way, we can manage all our model's input parameters. You see that our spreadsheet contains all these inputs. In green you see the input variables for our Crystal Ball model. Now we need to define the output. We created this model to calculate the expected losses. So, the L is our output. The expected losses depend on the input variables. As these inputs change, also the output will change. The Crystal Ball simulation will generate random values for the input variables. Random, but governed by the probability distributions linked to model these inputs. In each simulation trial, Crystal Ball will pick random values using these distributions. As the inputs change, so will the output. Since we do not test just one scenario but run, for instance, 10,000 trials, we will also get 1,000 results. It is as if our financial institution could live its life 10,000 times. We put the results in a histogram. Looking at the graph, we notice three things. 1. The results are dispersed over a wide range, which indicates there is much risk. 2. The graph has a long tail, which indicates there is a high probability of extreme losses. 3. The loan loss provisioning buffer of 25 covers less than half of the graph. There is more risk than our Excel model would suggest. The simulation's statistical data confirm this view. The mean of our simulation data is, which is more than the 25 in expected 29, 53 losses we calculated in Excel. The standard deviation, which is an indicator of uncertainty, is 15, 30, which equals about half of the mean. There is much risk. Moreover, we see elevated values for skewness and ketosis, which are harbingers of extreme events. Typically, financial institutions seek protection up to a certainty level. For instance, 95%. This means we need enough capital to protect the institution in 95 out of 100 scenarios. This equals 95% of the graph's surface. We see that the total capital buffer to reach the 95% mark amounts to 57.84. Of these 57.84, we already covered 25 in our loan loss provisioning. Our institution would hence need 32.84 in additional capital. 57.84 minus 25 is equal to 32.84. We call this extra capital buffer to reach the desired certainty level, economic capital. So, our financial institution has 25 in loan loss provisioning and 32.84 in economic capital. With these buffers, it is well protected in 95 out of 100 years. We conclude that our Monte Carlo modeling approach offers superior insights compared to our Excel model. The advantages are: 1. The middle of the distribution might be in an unexpected place. We saw that the original L calculation does not cover 50% of the graph. 2. We see the standard deviation, skewness, and ketosis and can measure the risk. 3. We can decide on the capital buffers needed for a certain protection level. Thanks for watching and good luck.